I believe we're living in days that righteous men and women have longed to see. I believe we're living in an eight rot zone, a time of favor. I believe we're living in the season of Joseph. There were two little boys outside playing in their front yard. The younger brother saw a caterpillar who had wound itself into a cocoon that was trying to break free as a butterfly. He took out his pocket knife and began to cut open the cocoon, thinking that he was actually helping the butterfly to be free. His older brother walked over to him and said, "Stop! Don't do that! You're going to hurt the butterfly." The younger brother had a perplexed look on his face. The older brother said, "I see you clearly don't understand." He said, "What you need to know is that when a caterpillar wraps itself in a cocoon, it goes through the metamorphosis of becoming a butterfly. The only way it actually gains the strength and ability to fly is through the struggle it goes through trying to break forth from the cocoon. If it doesn't go through the struggle, if it's not allowed to endure that, it will never gain the strength in its wings, it'll never gain the strength in its muscles to actually be able to fly once it is free. So you see that by setting it free, you're not helping it, you're actually hurting it. You're not giving it freedom, you're crippling it. You're never giving it the opportunity to be able to soar and to become everything that it was created to be." That's what it's like for many of us. We go through struggles in our lives, and it's through those struggles that we become transformed and are given the ability to soar to new spiritual heights. I believe for many of us, we have been in a season of preparation. We have been going through a time of struggle like Joseph. Joseph was given a dream by God that he shared with his family. His brothers didn't understand it. His father pondered it in his heart, but couldn't fully accept it. As a result of Joseph's dreams that his 11 brothers, father, and mother would ultimately bow down to him, it created great jealousy in the family, and his brothers actually tried to kill that dream. One day Joseph came to him, and from a distance his brother said, "Look, here comes the dreamer." What did Joseph's brothers try to do to him and to his dream? They tried to destroy it. They tried to kill it. They took him. They threw him in a pit. He was sold into slavery. Eventually, he was put into a prison because he was falsely accused by the wife of Potiphar. Many of you have gone through this experience in your own life. Your life has been in the pits. It seems as if you've been in a prison. You've cried out to God, and you don't understand what exactly is going on. Many of you have been given promises by God, dreams and visions for your life that you know come from the Lord. And like Joseph, you've had people laugh at you. You've had people call you a dreamer. You've had people discourage you. And it seems like God has forgotten you, like he's forsaken you, like you've been abandoned and you're all alone there. You've been going through the season of Joseph. God didn't forget about Joseph for 1 minute. Joseph had to go through what he experienced like the butterfly because God was actually preparing him for something greater. There is no spiritual promotion in the kingdom. There is no opportunity given for greater position in service of God unless we go through the trials and the temptation. Problems always precede promotion. You have to go through the pit and the prison in order to get to the palace. Yeshua had to endure death before he was seated at the right hand of the Father in power. There are no shortcuts to glory. There are no back doors for the things that God has for us, the ultimate purposes and plans that he had for his life. Joseph learned to completely trust God and depend upon him in his situation and circumstances. We never see Joseph complaining about God, complaining to God, or complaining about his brothers. He learned to trust God, he learned to serve God, and he put all his energy and his efforts and the best that he had to serve God wherever he was with joy and gladness, as the psalmist says, Ivdu et Hashem besimcha. Joseph knew his dreams that he had dreamt were from God, and he knew that God was ultimately going to bring it to pass, and therefore it seems as if he never wavered even for one moment. You can't kill a God dream. You can't curse what God has blessed. And many of you have been going through the labor process of giving birth to your God dream like Joseph. There is a dream and a destiny for your life. But before you can experience the joy of having new life in your arms, you have to go through the process of hard labor. The good news is, I believe we're coming into a season where the Josephs of this generation are about to be moved from the prison to the palace. If we're willing to trust, if we're willing to have faith, if we're willing to walk with God, if we're willing to believe what God has promised to us, no matter what, he who calls is faithful. You will see God's vision and purpose for your life come to pass. You will be given great favor and great opportunities. Let us be encouraged by the life of Joseph as we enter into this new season, as God brings forth the new leaders of this generation.